So tell me more about why you decided to go into this field.
You don't want the actual answer to that. You do not want the actual answer. I flipped coins. Like, I flipped coins. I had, like, a coin battle where, like, I had, like, different jobs, and I just kept flipping in the tournament to see who would win, and Engineer won.
What was it between?
Ooh, there was, like, 10. There was chef, teacher, doctor, psychiatrist, dentist. I forgot the other ones. Those were, like, the main ones. I forgot the other ones. But, yeah, there was a decent amount. Hello, my name is Billy Scott. I'm in in-house design section 3. I'm a roadway engineer for FDOT. What I feel like my job is to have fun, I guess, in a sense. But in all honesty, it's to design roads with to meet FDOT criteria. So I start the day planning about like what my day needs to be. Most of the time, it's me looking at CAD software, like for the stuff that I'm designing. CAD is computer-aided design. Aided or automated, but basically CAD is the software that we use to create like intelligent lines. We're able to create roadway schematics within the geographical location, like that has the intelligence. And we're also able to create lines and designs that have specific parameters that can be done like handheld, like with rulers or whatnot. But this is how we are able to use the computers to speed up that process. We do actually like go into CAD to design the actual plans for the roads. There's also a lot of times where you have to like QC the stuff that we already do, but there's a lot of things that come into plan preparation. So the supporting documents that we need to make. I guess one big misconception is like engineers are like people who just like hide in a desk and don't talk to people. There's a lot of talking. You get to meet a lot of different people. You get to know a lot of people, especially in DOT, where you talk and coordinate with different departments. Roads require a lot of work and a lot of people working behind it. So that's the one good thing, you get to develop your teamwork skills, your speaking skills. Because we also do have public meetings. We do meet with the cities, or I guess stakeholders also, to discuss the project. So yeah, if people talk about engineers don't talk at all, yeah, it's a completely different story here. In all honesty, it's just everything that's needed to design roads. The supporting documents, the CAD software itself, the quantity checks themselves, coordinating with outside agencies also, and also departments in DOT. I love the math part of it also. There's nothing better than having a string of numbers that are supposed to mean something. And when you actually check it on the field or check it in your CAD software, and when those two add up, it's like the best feeling in the world. I like the challenge, the opportunity to think about different solutions. You have to make sure that everything's right. You're there to promote mobility, safety. So whatever you're doing, you have to be sure that you are going to make it safer out there for people that are going to drive your road. When I first went to college, I guess like undergrad, like my first year, my dad, he's an engineer also. And he talked about his senior project and like the buildings he built for that. And that was like, I guess one of the happiest moments of his life. So it's like, engineers, like, and becoming an engineer seems like it's something that's rewarding. And I do agree with him in that sense. You know, when you actually see your road being built, it's a nice feeling. I love helping people in a sense. And you know, something that has to do with like public development, that pulls me towards that. One positive for engineering, right, is when you do a public meeting and you see the smiles on people's faces of like the roadway improvements. Or you see children's walking to school safely on the sidewalk that probably wouldn't be there if we didn't put a focus on ADA improvement. It puts a smile to my face.